YouTubers, it's your girl Shannon from Tesla and Chill, and it has been raining here in Seattle, but it finally stopped, so I am sitting here in the backyard, but you can see it's still a little bit yucky out. But I did want to catch up with you since our last video. You might remember it was like a big deal for Elon. He had a huge week. He had a baby, and then he had like a $700 million payout from Tesla, so he had a lot happening. So I figured maybe like his week would kind of start to slow down after that, but things are only heating back up. If you have been following Elon's tweets on Twitter, you probably know the story, but we are gonna do a quick recap right now. But before we jump into it, go ahead, hit that subscribe button and drop us a like. And also, you'll notice my shirt says grace. I think that's kind of like our theme word, at least in my family for 2020. Especially with all this like Corona stuff happening, like people have been like, I think people are just over Corona. So I think having patience with people is something we definitely need to remember. Not that I'm perfect by any means, I'm not Jesus, but I'm trying. Okay, so let's talk about things because I think people in California right now should be showing some grace. So if you have been following all the Corona stuff and the Elon stuff, you probably know that California has kind of reopened for business, but where the Tesla factory is in Fremont in Alameda County, that is still not open. It looks like from Elon's tweets, some of the health officials there, and I guess unelected like interim health officials, have overrode that state decision that California made, and they were not wanting Tesla to reopen up their factory. But Elon, being Elon, that's what he did. He has declared his factory open for business, and he is gonna be on the front lines with his employees. And of course the Fremont factory, I mean, that is like a big deal. That's where Tesla makes their Model 3s, their Model S's, their X's, and now their Y's. So Elon wants to get things back into production, and of course he had his way. But Elon isn't letting his employees do it by himself. He is gonna be a part of it. He tweeted that he will be on the line as well, so he will be right there. And I don't really know how it works exactly, because California, I guess, was open for business, but Fremont or Alameda County is not. So there's kind of talk about like him breaking the law, but like, does he get arrested? Does he not? If he does get arrested, he tweeted out he hopes that they will only arrest him, and he even tweeted where they can find him: on the line, in the factory, so they know where he's gonna be. The Alameda Health Department, they were shooting to hopefully try to like get things in order to have the Tesla factory open by May 18th. Again, that's not too far away at all, but since Elon has opened it now, we're kind of wondering what the consequences are gonna be of that. Now again, like we talked about, it could possibly be an arrest, because the fine, well, there's two fines really. You can be fined up to $1,000 per day for like violating those rules, or spend up to 90 days in jail. Now maybe $1,000 per day isn't a big deal for Elon, but I bet spending time in jail would be. especially if you have a newborn at home, I would not want to go to jail. And I don't know if I'd want to like compromise my baby's immune system by working on the lines. So I don't know why Elon made this decision. He sounds like he was just really eager to get back to work. And I mean, that factory employs like 10,000 people. So it's kind of a lot of people that were without work. Maybe they were collecting unemployment. I don't know. I hope so. But Elon has definitely had a big issue with this. It sounds like he's kind of had like a hard time just running his business in California in general. I think at one point he looked at maybe like opening up another factory in California, but there was like so much red tape that was happening, it would have taken years for that to happen, so he looked elsewhere. And now he has actually, if you've heard in the news, he's sued Alameda County for everything that's happened with this, just kind of delaying the factory opening. And now he's possibly talking about moving the headquarters to either Nevada or Texas. So moving the headquarters and factory, I think that would be like definitely a big undertaking, but who's to say it couldn't happen? Now I did think this was kind of funny, because if you remember, since the start of the Corona, Elon thought basically the panic was kind of dumb. I think he thought it was probably blown out of proportion. And he really criticized how the government had been handling everything. He thought it was time to get back to work. So I thought this was really funny. Donald Trump even got involved and tweeted that the Tesla factory should be reopened and things can go back to normal for them. And Elon even tweeted out a thank you to DT. So I thought that was kind of nice of him, especially considering like how outspoken he is against the government sometimes. Well, it is midday on the 12th, and so far I haven't heard any reports of arrests or scuffles or anything like that at the Tesla factory. Thankfully, hopefully people can just get back to making Teslas in peace. I mean, they're peaceful cars, let's just make them in peace too. And if Elon really did end up going to jail, I have a feeling Tesla support would be crazy. I bet like stocks would go up. I bet a ton of people would be like placing orders for cars. And do you remember when they did the Cybertruck like reveal and they threw that big metal ball at the window and the window cracked? And then they started selling like cracked window t-shirts. I have a feeling like Elon's mugshot would probably be on a t-shirt too. And I would buy it. But that's all I've got for now. Hopefully, again, we can just make cars in peace. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.